Hello everybody, I'm Jasper from Jabos Creations. In today's video I'm going to tell you all about how I worked with styrofoam and various methods that I used in the past and my favorite method of the moment. If you like my work and want to support it, then please subscribe to my channel. So let's start. I have been working with pre-bought styrofoam statues at the moment mostly, but I have also made self-made figures in the past. The first method that I'm going to talk about, and that was with this textile glue. This is Paverpol, which works great. You get a nice sort of plastic-like protective layer. And the reason why I need to add a protective layer is first off, styrofoam of course is easy to break, and secondly, a lot of the finish materials that you use, like for example varnishes, will damage styrofoam, and also certain type of glue can damage styrofoam, so therefore it's good to protect it. After I've added the layers of Paverpol, you can just go over it with acrylic paint. And then it is wise to add some type of varnish or epoxy resin to just have a final layer of protectiveness, especially if you would display them outside. Indoors, just as a hobby piece, you wouldn't necessarily need it. But if it's a professional piece and if you want to display it outside, you definitely need some extra protection. So after I've worked with Paverpol, it was great, but it was also extremely expensive. So I looked for other methods. Now you can coat styrofoam with things like certain types of hobby glue, wood glue. And they work all fine and also give you a nice protective layer, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted. So eventually I found out that people who work with aquariums actually use bathroom tile glue over styrofoam shapes to create their backgrounds. At least that's one of the methods. There are obviously other ways to create an aquarium back piece. Regardless, I really fell in love with the bathroom tile glue method, and that's the one I use mostly right now. I have tried various brands of bathroom tile glue, and really all of them worked. So the biggest advantage of using bathroom tile glue is that it creates a much stronger protective layer. In fact, you could probably just put bathroom tile glue on it and just leave it as is, especially if you find a bathroom tile glue in a color that you like. Another advantage is that it gives a sort of stone-like structure, which is really nice effect. Personally, I do like to sand it down, which is another advantage. You can actually sand it down to create a smoother surface if that's what you like. I like to sand it down because my acrylic paint markers have their nib will get damaged if the surface is too rough. After I sand it down, personally I like to add some more gesso to get a nice white background to paint on, and also I notice it helps to reduce the roughness of the surface a little bit more. But that's not necessary. You can just paint over it with acrylic paint, and then you could decide to either leave it as is, or one of my favorite ways to finish it is to add some layers of epoxy resin. It just gives such a nice, smooth, strong, protective layer and a nice shine to the piece. I really love it. Well, that's it for the main explanation. Now let's start working on these two lovely ladies. We'll be right back. Alright, I finished adding the layers of gesso. I used two layers this time, which usually is about the right to get the color that I want and also make the surface a little bit smoother again so that my nips of the Pascom markers are not damaged. But you can still see quite a lot of structure, which gives the figure a nice amount of character. So next up is to choose your weapons in terms of how you want to paint it further. Spray paint would work. Acrylic paint is what I'm going to use works. Posca and Molotov markers, which of course are acrylic based, will work. Basically anything that's able to stick to gesso will work. And then after you paint it, you will need to decide if you want to add some more protection in the form of varnish or a layer of epoxy or basically anything that you can add as a protective coat that works with acrylic paint or the material you choose to work with. But I will show you how I paint on these statues, add my figures and finish them up to a full statue that's worthy for my next exhibition in a different video. This video is focused on showing you how you can use my technique to paint your own styrofoam objects. I hope you learned a lot in this video. If you have any questions, then leave them in the comments down below. If you like my work and want to support it, then please subscribe to this channel, like and share this video. Of course, hit that notification bell so YouTube knows you want to be kept up to date with my work. And if you want to see more of my work, you can check out my various social media channels or visit my website where you can find my blog and store links where you can buy merchandise based on my work or my original artwork, which of course greatly supports my channel. But that's it for now. I wish you all a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next video.